Sound, mechanical vibrations transmitted through an elastic medium, traveling in air at a speed of approximately 1,087 feet per second at sea level.
Vibrations, the act of vibrating, the oscillating, reciprocating, or other periodic motion of a rigid or elastic body or medium forced from a position or state of equilibrium.
Vacuum, an empty space unoccupied. Sound waves are produced when a vibrating object pushes and pulls on the medium surrounding it. It therefore sends out waves in all directions. How humans make sound. Humans make sound through their vocal cords, which is the string that vibrates and can make a variety of pitches. Your muscles push air up your lungs and through the narrow opening between the vocal cords. The forces of the air causes the vocal cords to vibrate. Therefore, the vibrating vocal cords produce. How do humans detect sound? Humans detect sound by sound waves causing the eardrum to vibrate. The vibrations travel through the hammer, anvil, and stirrup to the inner ear. Cells in the cochlea detect the vibrations and send a message to the brain.
When someone gets an ear infection, that means that the eustachian tube passage is blocked. They can barely hear, and what they do hear is very muffled, and sometimes you get pus coming out of their ears. Ew.
Hey, Katie, do you know what Boyle's law is?
No, do you?
Yeah, actually I do. His law is sound doesn't travel through an experiment. I mean, duh.
Hey, Allison, do you know what happens if sound travels through different mediums?
Hey, Courtney, actually I do. Well, when sound travels through different mediums, the thicker or denser the medium is, the shorter it takes for you to hear that sound. But the thinner or less dense the medium is, the longer it takes for you to hear the sound.
Allison, do you know what a vacuum is?
Well, Katie, I think it's an empty space unoccupied, but I'm not sure. Am I right?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, can sound travel through a different vacuum?
Yeah.
Actually, that's where you're wrong. No, because a vacuum isn't made up of any particles, and sound only travels through matter made up of or consisting of particles. How do different mediums affect the speed of sound? Well, different mediums affect the speed of sound because sound travels faster through gases because they aren't as dense as liquids. They affect the speed because when the particles are packed closer together, it takes less time for the sound to escape. How do different temperatures affect the speed of sound? Well, different temperatures affect the speed of sound because sound travels faster in hot air than in cold air. This is because the mixture of gases and air aren't packed tightly together, and the higher the temp, the more gas particles wiggle and bounce. It takes less time for fast-moving particles to push against the other ones than it takes for slow-moving ones, therefore resulting in sound travels faster in warm air than in cold.
Hey, Courtney, if a far-off train made a sound, would it travel faster through air or through steel tracks?
Steel tracks, of course, Allison.
But I don't understand. How come?
Because steel is an elastic material with the particles packed very tightly together, and they vibrate back and forth, and because it's so dense, steel is the faster way.
Oh, I got it. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Hey, Allison, is there a set speed of sound?
Well, Katie, I think it is. Well, I don't know. I don't think there is, actually, because it all depends on the mediums. It travels at different speeds, and there isn't a set speed, but if you do know the medium and the temperature, I guess you could predict the speed, but there isn't a set speed because the different mediums, obviously, as we learned early in this video, it all depends on the mediums. So no, my final answer is going to be no. There are no set speeds.
Hey, Courtney, so if a tree fell in a forest and there was no one around to hear it, does it still make a sound?
Yes, because it isn't an airtight area, and there are still air and things around. There just won't be people around to hear it.
Oh, that makes sense. So technically, if anything falls and there's no one around to hear it, as long as there's still air and things, it still makes sound?
Yes.
Ah, nice.
How do different mediums affect the speed of sound? How do different mediums affect the speed of sound? How do different mediums affect the speed of sound?
here we go.
Fall off the chair.
Hey, quick. Would sound fall off train travel faster through steel tracks or air? Steel tracks is over. But why? How come? Because steel is an elastic material with the particles packed very tightly together and the vibrate back and forth in the same depth. Steel is the fast way to send it all to the same time.
Show me some love. Show me some.